So I'm part of an NGO called CartoNG. We are doing mapping and GIS for the humanitarian community. And we mostly support NGO by doing capacity building. And one key part of our job is identifying the tools and the data they can be using to improve their operations. So one of the aspects we've done recently is a research project on how UAVs or drones can be used in humanitarian action. It's a research project that is funded by the DG ECHO, so the humanitarian branch of the European Commission, and it's with a consortium with FSD, Zoe Environment, CartoNG, and the UAVator network. So basically, this project has several aspects. The first aspect was consolidating the existing documentation on what UAV can be used for in humanitarian world. We have also updated and worked on the UAVator wiki that provides a lot of information about regulations. So if you're interested into flying drones in different countries, you should look there. We've produced more than 10 case studies on projects that have been already implemented by different NGOs and UN agencies over the world to try to find best practices. We've conducted a couple of field tests to verify some of these assumptions. We've run a big survey on perceptions among many humanitarians around the world to better understand how they see UAVs and what they think it can be used for. We have run a couple of topical consultations, including one on mapping. And to conclude, the project is tackling four different aspects of UAV for humanitarians: mapping, monitoring, search and rescue, and payload delivery. And the numbers you see here are from the survey we run with humanitarian, and you can see that by far the most useful aspect they saw with UAVs is mapping. So it's directly connected to what I will say after on OSM. So here you have a few results on the perceptions that we got from the humanitarians. So as you can say, most humanitarians are generally speaking favorable of the use of UAVs and think that it can improve their operation as long as they are properly trained and framed. And the biggest need they saw for humanitarian organizations to better use drones were clear guidances and more training and experiences. So now I will present a couple of mapping examples we studied as case studies that were particularly successful because we think it could be a good example of what the best practices are. So both are tightly connected to HAT, actually. The first one is Dar es Salaam, so it's linked with Ramani Uria that was presented this morning. It was a coalition with local governments, national authorities, NGOs including HAT, universities, and the local tech community, which is basically the OSM community. And they run a very important mapping effort with UAVs that led to build a very detailed map of the area that can now be used even to do cadastral work. The second great example we've seen is a group of projects that have been led in Haiti with a strong implication of the OSM community too in partnership with the international organization for migrations. So they have produced a lot of imagery too with drones there that has been used in a wide set of projects by IOM and other organizations, including census, camp planning, protection and security project, and WASH projects. And what's interesting here is that this data was produced preemptively by IOM to do some camp planning and development projects. But we saw that actually when the Sandy hurricane hit, the fact that they had local capacity built within the organization and drones ready in the field allowed them to do an easy deployment. And it's the best use case we've seen during the whole project on humanitarian use during the disasters. So what we can conclude out of, in particular, these two case studies, is that the most efficient way to use UAVs in a humanitarian context is to have a local capacity pre-built before the disaster, and that is grassroots within the local tech community, local organization, that has the equipment, the authorization to fly, and the skills. What are a few key challenges, elements to consider when flying drones? I think it could be an interest to anybody. So now what we've seen is the challenge not so much in flying the drones because the technology is getting more and more user-friendly, but rather analyzing, storing, and using the data. So I put here a couple of projects. One of them is by HOT that are very promising in terms of data storing and sharing. What I said before, local resources should be considered first. Another thing that is very important and that we have highlighted is that drones are fancy, but they are not always the most fitting and cost-efficient tool. In many cases, you will have faster satellite imagery accurate from post-disaster than if you have to fly a foreign expert with his drone and get him authorization to fly. Other key elements are you need to be very open in communication and transparency with both local government and the communities. And it's also important to manage expectations, because if you fly UAVs in the field in a post-disaster context, people will expect aid to come afterwards. So it's important to tightly connect the UAV imagery production with the actual response, which is my third point here too. We saw that it's not recommended to fly drone just because you can. You need to have an actual use of this imagery afterwards. And so far, many use have been very pilots. And so it's not really demand driven in many cases yet. So what we recommended was to really put the need of like your response team first and only fly UAVs if they actually can use the data. Other important aspect is that most NGOs are now using small devices, which is good because they are felt like less threats, and most NGOs were not comfortable working in conflict areas so far. And finally, a very important point is coordination. So basically what we saw is that what we should seek is having this ecosystem of organization, local communities, tech communities, drone pilots that can work together, which is what we saw in Haiti, that can be then used both for development project and disaster response. And to conclude, we're having a feedback meeting during a conference we're running in 1 month in France, close to Geneva. So if you have thoughts and things to provide us feedback on drones, I strongly encourage you to check the program. It's a conference on GIS and humanitarian mapping, so I think it can be of interest to many of you guys. And the final report will be published in December for this research project. We'll have a very short executive summary. So part of this project was also a way to help people like you that want to use drones to convince around you of why they can be used for and how to better use it. So it's going to be a short document that you can show around you. And that's it. Thank you.